Introduction to numbers from 21 to 30.
Hello friends, I am the parrot. I welcome you to this lesson. Let's see what you will learn in this lesson. Numbers from 21 to 30 and reading those numbers as units and tens. Children, it is very hot today. Chotu thought, why not serve sherbet to all the people coming his lane today?
Mummy, today I want to serve sherbet to all the people coming to our lane. Would you help me?
Sure, Chotu. I will make sherbet for you. You keep them in a plate and carry.
Okay, Mummy.
Chotu, only 10 sherbets can be kept in one plate. Can you count and tell me how many glasses of sherbet is there in the plate?
Children, can you tell me how many sherbets are there in the plate? Come, let's see.
Mummy, there are 9 sherbets in the plate right now. Am I right?
Yes, Chotu, you are absolutely right. So this means, Chotu, that right now we have 9 units.
Yes, Mummy, I remember. Now if we put one more glass in this plate, it will be a group of 10 glasses. And we call it as 110.
You are absolutely right, Chotu. Here you go, Chotu. Your sherbet is ready.
Children, can you tell me how many glasses of sherbet Chotu's mother has made? Yes, you are right, children. Chotu has 2 plates of 10 sherbets each. It means 2 tens. This means Chotu has 20 glasses of sherbet. Together, Chotu and our team distributed all the glasses filled with sherbet. But they need more sherbet now.
Mummy, give us some more glasses of sherbet.
Okay, Chotu. Here you go. I have made some more sherbet. Keep it in this plate and take it outside.
Yes, Mummy. Okay.
Children, can you tell me how many glasses of sherbet were distributed by Chotu and Aarti together? Come on, let's see. First of all, Chotu distributed 2 groups of 10 glasses, that is 20 glasses of sherbet, and then 5 more glasses, that makes it 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. Chotu distributed 25 glasses of sherbet. Children, in these 25 glasses, 2 means 2 tens and 5 means 5 units. After some time, some more friends of Chotu came home and Chotu's mother made more sherbet for them. Let's see how many glasses of sherbet was made. Chotu distributed a total of 25 glasses of sherbet and after that 5 more glasses. So that makes it 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. That means 30 glasses which we write like this. So children, in 30 there are 3 tens and 0 units. So children, this means today 30 glasses of sherbet were made in Chotu's house. So children, that was all for today. In this video, you learned numbers from 21 to 30 and how to read those numbers as units and tens. In the next video, we will learn to read numbers from 31 to 40 and how to read those numbers as units and tens. Until then, bye children.
Introduction to numbers from 31 to 40.
Hello children. In the previous video, we learned numbers from 21 to 30 and read those numbers as units and tens. In this video, we will see some interesting examples of reading numbers from 31 to 40 and reading those numbers as units and tens. Today, Chotu went to buy pencils from the market. Let us see what he is doing with it now.
Now I have lot of pencils with me. I will count all the pencils. Firstly, here is a box of pencils with 10 pencils, that is 1/10. Then I took another pencil box containing 10 more pencils, meaning 1/10. After that, another pencil box containing 10 pencils, which means 1/10.
So children, can you tell me how many pencils Chotu has? Come on, let us see.
I have 3 groups of 10 pencils, which means 3/10, that is 30 pencils. And here are my 5 old pencils. So 30 pencils meaning 30 units with 5 more pencils, so 5 units more.
Children, can you tell me how many pencils does Chotu have now? Come on, let's see. Chotu had 30 pencils, followed by 31, 32, 33, 34, 35. So Chotu has 35 pencils in total. In 35 pencils, 3 means 3/10 and 5 means 5 units, which means total 35 pencils. After some time, Chotu's mother found some more of his pencils.
Chotu, see, I have got 5 more of your pencils. Keep these together as well.
Okay, mummy. I had 35 pencils and now 5 pencils more. And that means 5 units more. After 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40. So now I have 40 pencils.
Yes, Chotu, you are right. How many tens do you have now?
Mummy, 40 pencils, meaning I have 4 tens, isn't it, Mummy?
And units?
Mummy, there are no units in 40.
Yes, Chotu, there are only 4 tens in 40 and 0 units.
So children, that was all for today. In this video, we saw numbers from 21 to 40 and some interesting examples of reading those numbers as units and tens. In the next video, we will see some interesting examples of numbers from 21 to 40 and learn about some common mistakes which should not be done. Till then, goodbye friends.
Examples of numbers from 21 to 40.
Hello children, in the previous video we saw some interesting examples of numbers from 21 to 40. In this video we will see some more interesting examples of numbers from 21 to 40 and learn about some common mistakes which should not be done. Children, today a lot of guests are coming to Chotu's house. Food is being prepared with a lot of excitement. Chotu's mother has sent Chotu to the market to get paper plates and spoons.
Take, mother, I have got the plates and spoons.
Chotu, how many plates have you got?
Mummy, on this packet it's written 40 plates, meaning 4 groups of 10 plates and another group of 10 plates with it.
Hey, no, Chotu, you are reading it wrong. It's written here 40 plates, which is 4 groups of 10 plates.
But mummy, even 0 is written here. What about it?
Chotu, here 0 is written in place of unit, which means not a single open plate. And instead of 10, it is written 4, which means 4 groups of 10 plates, meaning 40 plates. So a total of 40 plates are there in this packet.
Okay, now I have understood, mummy.
It's evening now and guests are coming to Chotu's house. Chotu and Aarti are serving the guests.
Chotu, where have you kept the spoons that you had bought?
I have kept all the spoons in the kitchen. Come, I will show you.
Hey Chotu, These are how many spoons?
I have taken 30 groups of 10 spoons from the shop.
But 30 groups are a lot and these spoons seems very less. Come on, Chotu, let's count them again.
Okay, let us count these again.
Chotu, let us divide them into groups of 10 to count them. That will make it easier to count.
Yes, you are right. Let us do this. 10 tens, 10 tens, and another 10 tens. So this is a total of 30 tens.
Hey Chotu, you are counting it wrong. A group of 10 means 1 ten.
Children, do you think that Chotu has bought 30 sets of 10 spoons? Come on, let's see.
Chotu, these are just 30 spoons. There will be 30 tens and 30. 30 does not mean 30 tens, but 30 units. 30 tens would be too many spoons.
Okay, now I have understood. You are right, Aarti. Come on, let's take spoons for the guests.
So children, that's all for today. In this video, we learned that 0 does not mean 10 at the end of a number. And 3 tens means 30 units, not 30 tens. I hope you would have understood this topic. Bye friends.
Numbers from 41 to 45.
Hello friends, I am Parrot. I would like to welcome you to this course. Let us first see what will you learn in this chapter. Numbers from 41 to 45. Also, to read these numbers in the form of single units and groups of 10. While cleaning the house today, Pinky and Chotu found a packet of pearls. Looking at it, they thought they should make a beautiful necklace with these pearls. Pinky, how many pearls have you put in the necklace?
I have made the necklace with 25 pearls.
Pinky, how did you get to know that this necklace is made up of 25 pearls?
See, first of all, I put 10 yellow pearls in the necklace and then I put 10 red pearls. So 2 groups of 10 pearls each. That becomes 20 pearls. Then I put 5 yellow pearls more. So that becomes 20 and 5. That is 25 in total.
Alright, now let me also count my pearls. First I put 10 red pearls and after that I put 10 yellow pearls. After this, I put 10 more red pearls, which means my necklace has 3 sets of 10, which makes it 30 pearls. And there are 3 remaining pearls, so the total pearls are 33.
Our necklace is now ready. Now let us go and play Chotu.
Chotu and Pinky have a lot of fun while collecting different kinds of stones. Today they are collecting stones in a nearby garden. Pinky, today let us collect lots of stones.
Yes, Chotu, let us find different types of stones.
Chotu and Pinky start collecting stones.
Chotu, how many stones have you collected?
Wait, Pinky, let me count and tell you.
But these are so many stones. How should I count them? See, first of all, keep them in groups of 10 each and then tell me how many groups of 10 each do you have?
Pinky, I have 4 groups of 10 each.
So, 4 groups of 10 each means you have a total of 40 stones.
Pinky, look here, there are 5 other stones too. We have not counted them.
Alright Chotu, now let us count them too. First, we had 40 stones and now there are 5 more stones. So, they are 41, 42, 43, 44, 45. This means you collected 45 stones. Pinky, can you tell me how many groups of 10 and how many single units are there in 45? Yes, Chotu. 45 has 4 groups of 10 and 5 single units. You are absolutely right. Pinky, now let us take these home.
So children, that's it for today. In this video, you learnt about the numbers from 41 till 45 and how to read them in the form of single units and groups of 10. In next video, we will look at some more interesting examples of reading the numbers from 41 to 45 in the form of single units and groups of 10. And we will learn about the numbers from 46 to 50. So till then, bye children. Hello children. In the previous video, we learnt the numbers from 41 to 45 and we also learnt how to read them in the form of single units and in groups of tens. In this video, we will look at some more interesting examples of reading the numbers from 41 to 45 in the form of single units and groups of 10. Also, we will learn about the numbers from 46 to 50. Today, Pinky and Chotu are very happy. They have to go out for a birthday celebration of their friend Sonu today evening. They have got different colored stars from the market. With the help of these stars, they will decorate a birthday card for Sonu.
Pinky, see, it seems that there are many stars in this packet.
Chotu, come on. Let us count all these stars. I have divided these stars in 4 groups of 10 each. This means 10, 20, 30 and 40. So, the total number of stars are 40. So, now how many stars are left, Chotu?
Now there are 7 stars left. This means 40 stars and 7 stars. So these will be 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47. So the total number of stars are 47. Right, Pinky?
Yes, Chotu. This means we have 4 groups of 10 and along with this 7 single units.
Now let us decorate the birthday card with the help of these stars. Today, a lot of guests are expected to visit Chotu's home. Chotu's mother has sent Chotu to get 50 spoons from the almira.
Pinky, let us go and get spoons for guests from the almira.
Chotu, it will take a lot of time to count 50 spoons.
No, Pinky, see, these are 4 groups of 10 spoons each. Children, can you tell how many spoons have Chotu and Pinky found? Let us see. Right now, we have got 4 groups of 10 spoons each. So, these are 40 spoons in total.
How many more spoons do we need, Chotu?
We need a total of 50 spoons. So it means we need 5 groups of 10 spoons each. Right now, we have 4 groups. So this means we need 1 more group of 10.
Come on, Chotu. Let us count the spoons. So these are 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47,
48, 49, 50.
So these are 5 groups of 10 each, which means 50 spoons. Pinky, now let us go and give the spoons to mother. Children, you just saw that Pinky and Chotu had 47 stars and 50 spoons. Can you tell how many groups of 10 and how many single units are there in these? Let us see. There are 4 groups of 10 and 7 single units in 47. And there are 5 groups of 10 in 50. There are no separate single units in 50. And that's why 0 single units. Children, so that's it for today. In this video, we saw the numbers from 41 to 50 and some interesting examples of looking at these in the form of groups of 10 and single units. In the next video, we will see some more interesting examples of numbers from 41 to 50 and we will learn about some common mistakes which should not be done. Till then, bye children.
Interesting examples of numbers from 41 to 50.
Hello children! In the previous video, we saw some interesting examples of numbers from 41 to 50. In this video, we will look at some more interesting examples of the numbers from 41 to 50 and we will learn about some common mistakes which should not be done. It is the winter season. Chotu and his mother are making crispy snacks. Papad sitting on the roof. Chotu is also helping his mother.
Chotu, I am keeping 10 papad each in every plate. You keep these plates under the sun so that the papad can dry up.
Alright, mother. I will keep them.
Chotu, I gave you 5 plates to be kept under the sun. Can you count and tell me how many total papad have you kept under the sun to get dried up?
Mother, I have kept 5 groups of 10 papad each, which means a total of 15 papad under the sun.
No, Chotu, you are counting wrong. If one plate has 10 papad, then how many papad will there be in 5 plates?
But mother, if we add 10 papad and 5 plates, then the total will be 15 only, right?
Yes, Chotu, you said it right. But 15 only has 1 10, 1 group of 10 and 5 ones. But here, there are 5 groups of 10 each, which means 5 times 10, 5 tenors. So, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. So, in total, there are 50 papad.
Alright, now I have understood, mother. These are 50 papad and not 15. Today, the teacher asked all the children to get rajma beans and some small packets from home. They have to show 43 rajma beans with the help of sets of 10 rajma beans and some loose rajma beans.
Aarti, we will have a lot of fun today. See, I have 4 packets with the rajma beans. How many packets have you made?
Chotu, I have made 3 packets. In 3 packets, there are 10 rajma beans each. Now I want 4 rajma beans more. Then the total will be 43 rajma beans. Right, Chotu?
No, Aarti. You are not counting it correctly. One packet has 10 beans of rajma and you have made 3 packets like these. So, that makes it 30 rajma beans, which means 3 sets of 10 each. And along with this, 4 beans, which means 4 single units. So, in total, there will be 34 rajma beans.
but we want 43 rajma beans.
Oh yes, Chotu. I want 4 packets of 10 rajma beans each and along with this 3 single beans and then there will be 43 rajma beans.
Yes, Aarti. 4 packets with 10 rajma beans each means 4 groups of 10 rajma beans and along with this 3 loose rajma beans means 3 single units. Then the total will be 43 rajma beans.
So children, this is all for today. In these videos, we learnt about the numbers 41 till 50. I hope that you all have understood this topic well. Bye friends.